this video, we are going to jump right into photo editing and some basics in Affinity Photo while using your Wacom One. We're going to go into File, Open, and choose the photo that you would like to edit. So today I have prepared a photo that I took of my traditional art that, you know, the colors are looking a little dull. So we're going to use some basics to kind of help amplify the colors. To do this, you can simply go to the Adjustment tab. Let's say we think we want the whites to be a little bit brighter and then the darks to be a little bit more full. We can go into Levels, just click on it. Let's see Darken. This is going to give you a histogram. And you can simply adjust this by dragging the white level where you see the spike happens on the graph. And maybe the darks are a little bit too dark, so we can drag this dot towards the left a little bit. And just like that. You can close the levels and it's going to automatically save it for you in the layers menu. But even then, we like to adjust maybe some of the white balance. So I'm going to go into white balance and choose cool. The differences are very subtle, but you can also use the slider to adjust them to however you like. Let's go to the layer tab that is right next to the adjustment tab. In the layers tab, you will see all of the layers laid out in order. We have the two adjustment layers that we just made that were automatically created for you. And if you want to hide them, you can simply click on the check that is to the right of this panel. You can see this is after, and that's before. Now we want to create a brand new layer called App Pixel Layer. Let's select the Clone Brush tool on the left side of your toolbar, or S. If you look at the source menu on the top, make sure to click on the drop-down menu and go to Layer and Below. We'll explain this in a little bit. We have this piece of art, but I find the shadows to be a little bit distracting from the washi tapes, so I want to edit that out. And in order to do that, you will want to sample the empty areas that is on the original image. And this is why we want to source it from the current layer and below, because right now the current layer that we have selected is a completely empty one. But this will allow you to really freely adjust and add to or experiment without affecting your original layer. To do this, we want to make sure we have all of the details. So let's zoom in. And use the navigator to pan to this side. And now we have a closer look to the shadows. From here, we can hit Alt and click on the areas you would like to sample and simply draw over it. Now it's copying the little decoration that is right here. So we don't want that, and we want to sample this area again. It takes a lot of patience and time to do a good photo editing. We see like the edges aren't really perfect, so we can use the eraser tool or E on your keyboard and just erase a tiny bit on the side. Ctrl Z, your best friend in all digital art. And since, you know, we do want some naturally casted shadows still, so we want to make it a little bit more natural. To do that, we click on the opacity menu over here and use the slider and just put it down to maybe 52, 53, because I'm not about giving you the whole number. See? Before and after. What I noticed too was that the right side seems a little bit too dark still. So I want to go and use the select brush tool or W on your keyboard. And I can just brush over this part and it'll automatically select the edges that it detects, making a very nice clean selection over here. And from here, I go back to the adjustments. I can go into brightness and contrast and just lighten this part. So when a selection is made, all of your adjustment that will happen is within that selection. So let's see, I make the contrast the brightness a little bit higher, just slightly. And let's go back to the layer tab to see before and after. And from here, all you have to do is hit Control D to deselect. And once you look at your overall image and you are sure you're happy with it, you don't want to have a million different layers in your layer panels, which we all know it happens. We can do Shift, click to select all of the layers that are affecting your image and right click. I have right click mapped to my pen. So I simply just click on the button on the bottom of the pen and right click and select Merge Visible. Once you have selected Merge Visible, you will see a new layer gets created on top of it. This is because they merged all of the images that you were seeing before onto a top new layer. So if you see that if I turn off all of the other layers, you can still see it because the top one has all of the information. This is really convenient for you to keep all of your older layers in case you need to go back to them. But at the same time, it gives you one single layer that is easy to navigate with. But remember to name it by clicking on it and say this is the final edit. And there you go. That's the very basic editing inside AFFINITY PHOTO using your Wacom One. Hope that video was helpful to you, and we'll see you in the next one.